Welcome. In this video, we learn to make a presentation using Beamer. Actually, this is similar to PowerPoint presentation, but it has the upper hand due to its strong ability to format the document so that it can look nicer. And also, it's completely free. The Beamer package is installed with your Miktex distribution. If it is not installed in your system, then you can install through Miktex console. The process you would have seen in my other videos. First of all, we'll discuss about some default settings related to page layout and font sizes. The predefined paper size in Beamer is 128mm by 96mm. This is the length and this one is the width. The aspect ratio is 4:3. In PowerPoint, the default aspect ratio is 16:9 and here it is 4:3. Default font size is 11 point, which corresponds to 22 point at the full screen mode. Beamer scales the font size. For the title of the presentation, large command is used. Normal size command is used for author, and for the institute information, script size command is used. For the date, default font size is used. The default font used by Beamer is Computer Modern Sans Serif. For the frame or title slide, large command is used. Section font size in table of contents is normal size. Now come to page layout. The default margins in left and right sides are 1 cm. 0 cm is used for the top and bottom margins. The space for header or footer is 0.5 cm. This length or this length. In Beamer, a single page is defined with frame, and this is similar to the slide used in PowerPoint. Now we'll start making presentation using Beamer. I'll open Tech Studio. We'll create new file. Save this. You can write any name, but it's good if you don't leave any blank space in the file name. First command, as usual, document class. It's a Beamer. Then document environment, where we'll put our main content. In the next, we'll create slides, which are known as frames in Beamer. And for this, we'll use frame environment, begin frame, end frame. Inside this environment, we can put our content. For example, if I write Beamer presentation. Now I'll add some paragraphs and we'll see the default formatting. Here, as we can see that the text are aligned vertically at the center of the page. We can shift this at the top. In optional bracket, just write T. T for top, B for bottom, and C for center. If you want to print the content of each slide at the top, then you can define this globally. At this place, just write T. But I'll not suggest to use this at this place, because for some particular frames, we need center alignment. Here the text are left aligned. We can fully justify it with the help of Raget2e package. After that, just write justifying, / justifying. We can also change the vertical spacing between paragraphs with the help of par skip command. Write set length, / par skip. Let's check with 5 point. Alright, default font size is 11 point as I have discussed. Now I am going to use 12 point, which will be 24 point in the full screen mode. We can also add a frame title. At this place in curly bracket, just write the title of the frame. Next, we'll change the margins in left and right sides. Just write set Beamer size. Text margin left, text margin right. We can change the font size of the normal text. I'll choose script size. We can consider the same frame size what PowerPoint uses, which is 16:9. And in Beamer, default is 4 by 3, aspect ratio 4 by 3. So at this place, just write aspect ratio. For the aspect ratio of 16 by 9, just write 169. Here length is 160 mm and height is 90 mm. The aspect ratio 4 by 3 also produces the good results. We will also change the default computer modern font. Choose the font which supports both text and math. One more setting I want to do. Actually, I want to shift the frame title a little bit to the right side. For that, we can use a set Beamer template. Element name. Element is frame title. Predefined option which I want to change. Default. In another optional bracket, just define the spacing. So first just mention the side and then value. Left skip. Let's check with 5 mm. Alright. Now we have almost done with the page layout and font sizes. In the next, we'll build the title page. Either in the Primble or in the document environment, just give the information about title, author, institute and date. Author. We can also add email ID. Change the font size. Institute. Date. Title information will come in the very first slide. Insert one new frame. Just write make title. Now compile your file. This is our title page. If you want, you can add a subtitle as well. For a nice presentation appearance with minimal effort, it would be better to apply a theme to our slides or frames. Although we can completely customize all the settings, predefined settings, and we will do that in a separate part. Several themes have been designed for the Beamer. We can see from the internet or with the Tech Studio itself. Go to Wizards, Quick Beamer Presentation. At this place, you can see number of themes. The appearance of the presentation you can see at the right side. I am going to use this one, East Lansing. Using this wizard, you can quickly create a presentation. Provide author information, title, and press at OK. For applying a theme, we have to use a use theme command. Theme name, East Lansing. This is the header. Footer. Title information are also coming in the footer. We can use short name. Just in optional bracket write the short name. Font size of the date we can decrease. In the right most current slide number with respect to total slide is coming. Here in the title frame, we can add the logo. For this, just use a title graphic command. Include graphics. Define the logo size. Logo name. I have here some images. This is the logo. I'll save this folder in the working folder. Just write graphics path. Folder name forward slash. No need to add graphics package. In Beamer it has already been added. I want to print the logo after author information. So just comment this and go to author information and at this place use double backslashes. We can change the spacing, vertical spacing. We can also add logo in each frame. Just use logo command. This logo is also coming in the title page. We need to remove. Right plane. Title frame will be plain. We can also suppress the title page slide number. Just write no frame numbering. Compile one more time. So this one will be counted as the first slide number. Now the remaining part is easy to handle, such as figure, table, math, list, references. For example, I'll include one more frame for the lists. Since we have to repeatedly use this environment frame, it would be better to create a macro for the frame. Just go to macros, edit macros, write the name of the macro, define the shortcut for this macro, choose normal and write these two lines. Press at OK. Now we don't need to write this environment every time. Either use Shift plus F1 or go to macros and press here. Write the title of the frame. Creating list is very easy. You can use itemize environment or enumerate or description. Font size, we can take script size. We can shift this at the top. One more slide I'll create. This time I want to print three lists side by side. For this we have several options. Either we can use a tabular, mini page or columns environment. In Beamer generally columns are used. Just write begin columns, end columns. Inside this environment, we'll create each column with the help of column command. I want to create three columns. On the scale 1, each column width will be 0.33, around 0.33. For the two columns, it will be 0.5 of the total line width. We should take little less of the defined width. Similarly, we'll create second column. Third column. Default vertical alignment is center. We have two options for aligning the columns at the top, lowercase t and uppercase t. Lowercase t aligns the base lines of the first lines, whereas uppercase t aligns the tops of the first line. Capital T option is very useful when you have to align a graphic which suddenly drops down with the lowercase t option. At this place, after begin columns, in optional bracket, just write t. There are some predefined blocks in Beamer which we can use for nice looking. Add one more frame. Frame title. Write begin block. Block title. And content. Second block is example block. Title. Third one is alert block. Actually each block is only differentiated by color. Not running. Actually by mistake this one has shifted from the last frame. it's going out of the frame. We need to use columns. I'll change the width of the column. Inside the block, we can add a figure table or any other content. Now I'll include one more frame for the figures and tables. Shift F1. Here I have some images I'll include. In presentation, we don't need to write a caption, so no need to use a figure environment. Just write include graphics. We have to adjust the position of each image. For placing more than one image, it would be better to use columns. We can change the size. Alright, each image can be labeled. After adding each image, just use a double backslashes. Then just label the image alphabetically or any other format. In the same frame, out of the columns, we can add some content. It's not a problem. For example, this time I want to include one table. Similar to figures, for the tables we don't need to write a caption. So just use a tabular environment, not table environment. For the nice looking table, I have added these commands. These commands work with one package, that is book tabs. I'll add in the preamble. I'll also reduce the size. It's always better to put figures or tables in a separated columns, and in other columns just provide the information related to figures or tables. Just insert a new frame for the mathematics. Insert it from the macros or just press Shift plus F1. Similar to figures or tables, here for the equation labeling doesn't play important role. For the display math, we can use $4 or we can use a square bracket with the backslashes. For example, I'll write one display math. I'll write few more mathematical expressions. Now in the same frame, I want to include one image. This one and this one. I'll put in two columns. Each column width is 0.45 of the total line width. Alignment is not correct. Let us check with the capital T. In the next frame, I want to discuss about linking the inter slides or adding an external file. Top alignment, also increase the space between each item. This works with the Enumerate package, which has been already loaded with Beamer. Here we will see the linking within the same document, linking a particular slide with an external document. It could be audio, video, graphics or any other document. We will also see the process of embedding video and animations. This part we will see in a separate video in details. Last one is the references. For printing references, either we can use a simple method or a BibTeX method. Both we have seen in basic LaTeX learning. First I will use simple method. Just use the bibliography environment, and after bib item command, provide the information related to the reference. We can cite. Now I am assuming that I have several references. As you can see that it's going out of the frame. So here at this place in optional bracket just write allow frame breaks, also T for top alignment. Now references are coming properly, but title of the references in each frame is different. Go to preamble, write set beamer template, frame title continuation, / frame title, write the title of the references, we can also remove these icons and add numbers, again write set beamer template, bibliography item. In optional bracket just write text. Alright. Now we'll see BibTeX method. Write bibliography style as usual we do. And bibliography. File name. I have already created one bib file. I'll include this bib file in the same working folder. Go to preamble and add netbib. This is the bib file. It's a good idea to print the references in the footnote or in the main content area. And also I would suggest to use abbreviated references. You can discard the title and also you can use abbreviated journal name. I'll show how to print the references in the main content area. Go to preamble. Load one package, that is bib entry. No need to use numbers. After begin document, just write bibliography style and also load the bib file. But this time we will have to use no bibliography. Just use bib entry command for printing a reference. In curly bracket, write the bib key. Here full reference is coming. I want to use abbreviated. For this I have modified one style. This one. I'll include in the same working folder. Copy the name. we can change the font size. Go to Preamble and write let old bib entry, renew command, bib entry, use one curly bracket, then font size tiny. I want to print each reference in square bracket, / old bib curly bracket, one argument. Just remove the round brackets. Now it's coming perfectly. Few more slides I'm going to include. For accessing the large font, I have used a font size command. Next, appendix. Add frame. Here, just before a query, I want to include one more slide. I have put the content inside a block environment. Here, appendix frame number I want to exclude from the total frame number. So for this, we need to use one command. Just go to Preamble, set beamer template, page in head foot, page number in head foot. In curly bracket, just write appendix frame number. It should be inside square brackets. So this is the first frame of the appendix. Second frame. Total number of frames of the main content is 9. Now we will divide our presentation in different sections. Section command should be used outside of the frame environment. This is introduction. If you wish to print your section title into header, then you should use a short title in optional bracket. If you are printing your list of references in a separate frame, then for this also you can create one section. I am leaving. For appendix, there is no need to create any section. Now each section title is coming in the headline. After title frame, we can create a table of contents for printing all the sections. This is the title frame. Write the title of your table of contents. Just use a table of contents command. This heading we can print in the headline, in header. Just write section. For printing only in headline, just use optional bracket. We can view the PDF. Just open in full screen mode. Now I am going to stop this tutorial at this point. In the next part, we'll completely customize this for more harmonious appearance. Till then, bye bye. Thanks for watching.